Hello, and welcome to one of my midweek vlogs. Today, I'm out and about once again. I'm not in Hadley, but I'm in Frizingfield. I'm actually at the home where my mum is blessed to live. It has a gorgeous garden, lovely surroundings, and yes, you can hear Milo barking in the distance. And the reason that our little fat friend is barking in the distance is because I have just rescued a fish that was lying on the lawn here. And the reason that he or she was lying on the lawn is because he had obviously been taken from wherever he'd been living, a pond somewhere nearby, by a bird, and he had been dropped on the lawn of my mum's. And Milo, of course, found him very, very quickly, and can't quite make him out. But if I just show him to you, there we are. No more than 2 minutes ago, he was practically dead and out. Well, I'll put him back into the water. And he's recovering. 2 minutes ago, you'd probably have said his life on Earth was at an end. And I just want to talk to you just for a few moments about being a fish out of water. You see the absolute reality of what that means to that poor little fish in the bucket, having Milo barking at him, wondering what on earth is going on. Because in this world, there are many people that have lives and they feel to themselves, I'm like a fish out of water. I don't fit in. I don't have the right accent. I don't have the right job. I don't have the right home. I don't have the right car. I don't have the right color of skin. And because of that, there is racism against me. There are horrible threats against me. There are all sorts of manner of insults that come my way. I walk into a room, I walk into a community and people stare at me. I only heard yesterday on the radio of a couple of people talking, and one of them as a black person was saying, I just went into this community and people stared at me because I stood out, because in that community, there's no one quite like me. Maybe you feel like that, that you just don't fit in. Well, I want to tell you right now that you are loved by God. I want to tell you right now that Jesus Christ loves you. I want to tell you right now, Jesus Christ on earth stood up for the victimized, stood up for the lonely, stood up for men and women and young people for that matter, who needed to hear that they were valued and loved and they are important. And I want you to know that right now. I want you to know that you are valued by God. You are important to him. Jesus does care for you. He loves you. And here on earth, he stood up for people that really sat on the sidelines. Those that were lonely. Those that through being disabled were beggars on the side of the street. Blind people, lame people. And he talked to them. And he took an interest in them, and he just showed them his love, that he cared. And even when he died on a cross in Jerusalem, outside the city wall, he is being crucified with two thieves or robbers on either side of him. One of them isn't that interested, and it just takes the mickey out of Jesus on the cross and basically says to him, well, you know, if you saved others, how about saving yourself now? But yet Jesus then turned to one of them and said, today you'll be with me in paradise. That one realized that he needed to be forgiven. He was rightly being crucified, but he realized that the one in the middle, Jesus Christ, was not rightfully being crucified. He was an innocent man in every way. And even when he is dying on a cross, he takes an interest in him. I want you to know today, if you feel like a fish out of water, if you feel lonely, afraid, ostracized, that Jesus cares for you, that Jesus loves you, and that he wants you also to be one of his followers. You too can be one of his followers. And then you need not feel ever again like a fish out of water. You will be part of a family that is enormous all across the world. There are men and women and young people and children that love Jesus Christ. Millions and millions of followers of Jesus. Every nation, every tribe, every culture, there are followers of Jesus. All kinds of different people, all kinds of ages, all kinds of different colors of skin. It matters not to God. It matters not to Jesus. You are welcome in his family because Jesus died on the cross for you. And if you receive his forgiveness, if you ask him to be Lord and Savior of your life, then you are part of a worldwide family, which is glorious and wonderful. And you need no longer be a fish out of water because you belong to a king, the King, Jesus Christ. So I thank you for listening. And I pray that this will be of value to every one of you that is listening. We're going to now sing a song together if you want to join in or just listen to the words of it. That reminds us of 10,000 reasons to praise God. It begins, "Bless the Lord, O my soul," and reminds us that God loves us, God cares for us, and that Jesus came to forgive us of our wrongdoing. And because of that, we can praise him. This storm is passing. Jesus is with us. And I pray that you'll know that you're special to God and loved by him. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Take care. Bye.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never.
The end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
worship your holy name.